Welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted to be joined on the line now by Sarah Howell, who is the CEO of Arecor Therapeutics, and a very warm welcome to you, Sarah.
Thank you so much. Nice to see you.
And you've announced this morning, Sarah, that the first patient has been dosed in a trial of AT278. So perhaps you can tell us a bit about the trial itself.
Yeah, sure. So AT278 is a insulin product that we have under development at Arecor. So here we've used our Arestat technology platform to develop a very highly concentrated but very rapid acting insulin. And this particular trial here, we're looking at AT278 compared to a gold standard insulin that's available today. It's called Nova Rapid. It's an insulin from Novo Nordisk, and also another insulin from Eli Lilly, which is called Humulin RU500. And what we're looking to show here is we'll be comparing AT278, the pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic properties of AT278 against Nova Rapid and Humulin RU500, which are essentially the two treatment options available to patients today.
And Sarah, this is a trial specifically for people with type 2 diabetes. So what's the reason for that focus?
Yeah, and this is really important because what we're seeing is that there are a growing number of people with diabetes, particularly those with type 2 diabetes, who are requiring higher daily doses of insulin to help them manage their blood glucose control. And for these patients, there are essentially two treatment options available, or two insulin-based treatment options available for them today. And the first is that they can take the gold standard rapid or ultra-rapid acting insulins available to them, such as Nova Rapid, which we're comparing against within this study. And the reason they might choose that insulin is that it's a very rapid acting insulin, so it gives them good blood glucose control. But because they need high daily doses of insulin, it means that they often have to take high injection volumes or multiple injections multiple times a day. Or they can select a very concentrated insulin. So this is Humulin RU500. It's the same concentration as AT278 that we're developing. And here they get the benefits of reduced injection volume, fewer injections a day, but Humulin RU500 is more of an intermediate acting insulin. So this means that it's more difficult to control blood glucose with Humulin RU500, particularly around meal times. So essentially with AT278, we're looking to develop an insulin that meets both of those requirements: lower injection volume, potentially fewer injections a day, but a very rapid acting insulin. So you're not compromising there on blood glucose control. And for type 2 diabetic patients, this is a growing need. It's linked with the obesity pandemic as well. So that's why it's important that we study AT278 in this patient population, will be the primary target patient population for this product.
Understood. So it is something there is an urgent need for. So when do you think we're going to get a readout from the trial?
Yeah, so obviously with the first patient dosing, that's a great milestone for us now, and means that we can continue forward there with recruiting those patients and performing the study. And we'd be, as long as everything continues to run on track here, which we expect it to do, we'd be expecting then to report out on our headline results in Q4 of this year.
Okay, now Sarah, one final question from me. This is all building towards your artificial pancreas that you've been working on, isn't it? So how do you feel like the project is progressing overall?
Yeah, it's one of the other benefits of having a more concentrated but very rapid acting insulin is that an AT278 could then be used to enable that next generation of insulin delivery devices, so insulin pumps essentially. And it's very much a need and a drive towards miniaturizing these pumps, so much smaller body-worn patch pumps, and also enabling patients to wear them for longer. And this is all around simplifying and reducing the burden of the disease management itself. And actually what's important around AT278 is that Arecor has a leadership position here scientifically and in development, that we're the only company that's been able to develop a very concentrated but very rapid acting insulin. So real potential here for this to be the insulin that can really enable that next generation of insulin pumps, smaller, longer wear time, and really a next step again towards those systems such as artificial pancreas.
Fantastic. Well, very best of luck with it, Sarah. It's been great to have you on as always, and we'll catch you again soon, I'm sure.
Great. Thanks, Thomas.